join the resistance. As I watched, a great storm wind came from the north, a large cloud with flashing fire, a bright glow all around it, and something like polished metal gleamed at the center of the fire. From within it, figures in the likeness of four living creatures appeared. This is what they looked like. Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 4 and 5. Flying saucers are supposed to be a product of science and not religion, right? Well, this is the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception in Mobile, Alabama, my hometown. As you walk down the center aisle, there are seven different crests painted on the marble floor. The very top of each crest features what looks like the profile of a classic flying saucer type UFO. Each model slightly different from the one before it, and they all seem to be sort of beaming up the cross itself. Throughout recorded human history, there have always been depictions of non-human intelligences, exotic tractor beam and other technologies, and mysterious saucer-shaped craft, appearing again and again in everything from cave paintings to 14th century frescoes to medieval and modern art. In this painting of the Virgin Mary, you can clearly see a man staring up to the sky looking at a saucer-shaped UFO. There are clues to the true nature of reality hidden in the shadows of both historical and contemporary sculptures. This huge metal angel guarding the entrance to the steeple in Mobile, Alabama is magnificent enough by itself. However, there may be a hidden message encoded in its shadow that can only be seen at certain times of the day. But what does it all mean? Have we been worshiping space aliens for thousands of years, like von Däniken believes? No. Perhaps humans from the future have traveled back in time to witness certain historical events. Wouldn't it be fun to travel back in time to watch Moses part the Red Sea or Jesus turn water into four loco? If you look at the shape of some of our first attempts at time travel, the flying saucer platform becomes quite familiar. If you subscribe to von Däniken's ancient astronaut theory, you believe that both Jesus and God are nothing more than high-tech extraterrestrials that came to Earth to mine gold and genetically engineered primates with their alien DNA to create us humans to mine it for them. Then these gods of ours just upped and left us here to fend for ourselves on Earth. Though that does explain some of the anomalies in ancient art and the creation story, it does not compute when contemplating the bigger picture. If they were gods, then who created them and everything else that we experience in our matrix? God, the real God, would exist both within and outside and above the simulation that he created. God would be the code of the matrix itself. This means to me that the truth lies somewhere in the middle, and that the real God, spoken of throughout the Bible, may use flesh and blood creatures as his emissaries in the orchestration of his master plan. If you think about it, the creatures that God would use as his so-called angels would have to be part of the matrix in which they operate, and God wouldn't choose beings on the lower end of the technological spectrum. God's agents would represent the absolute pinnacle of creation in every aspect. The best of the best, the most technologically advanced, most intelligent, highest level of moral compass and battlefield superiority, etc. Just as the agents in the Matrix had supernatural qualities, interdimensional creatures would have the same sort of abilities in our reality. However, God himself would exist beyond the limits of our multidimensional reality. In Genesis, it says that the earth is flat. However, if you believe in science, which most people do, then the earth is clearly round. To an extra-dimensional creature, or God, our three-dimensional round earth may very well appear flat. In the same way that Mario and Luigi's two-dimensional world seems very full to them, but appears very flat to us on a two-dimensional television screen. So in a way, religion and science are both correct. Theoretically, the earth could be both round and flat simultaneously. Science, the religion of today, represents everything that Lucifer and Prometheus have been trying to accomplish since the fall: to give man godlike powers and technology. Well, man is not ready. Man is having enough trouble managing manlike powers. Godlike powers would surely mean the destruction of mankind.
This is one reason why secret societies like the Freemasons delegate when and where to uncover the individual secrets of the mystery schools that they protect. Man just is not ready.
Lucifer and his demonic cronies, Azazel, Moloch, Asherah, etc., may in fact be parading about our solar system as something that only a scientific mind would accept. And what screams science more than space aliens? Not many people would agree to sit down and have a beer with a demon, but almost everyone would love to have a beer with a space alien. Although the universe does seem to electively dictate which information it wants to put in front of you, in the end, it really comes down to what you choose to believe. Please comment below and tell me what you think. Until next time, please remember to stay vigilant, keep your eyes to the skies, and enjoy the revolution on Resistance Radio TV with Chuck Blackman. Please remember to subscribe right now.